Hi everyone, I'm Edward Barnes, and in this video we'll explore the song Somewhere from the Broadway musical West Side Story. First, we'll look at how the song was created, the music and the lyrics. Then, we'll put them both together to see what the song was like when it first appeared on Broadway in 1957. This is Somewhere, Exploration of a Song. West Side Story premiered on Broadway in September of 1957. Leonard Bernstein wrote the music, Arthur Lawrence wrote the book, the young Stephen Sondheim made his Broadway debut writing the lyrics, with the entire production conceived, directed, and choreographed by Jerome Robbins. The song Somewhere is featured in the second scene of the second act of West Side Story. It follows a scene called I Feel Pretty, in which the teenage leading lady Maria fantasizes about a date with her new boyfriend, Tony. As she sings, Maria is unaware that Tony has just killed her brother, Bernardo, in a rumble between the show's two rival gangs, the Jets and the Sharks. At the end of I Feel Pretty, Maria learns of her brother's death, and she runs off to her bedroom, alone and crying. Just then, Tony appears at the window. And it's this moment when Tony comes in through the window and faces Maria that the creators have decided would best be told as a dance, a ballet. This is Arthur Lawrence's original manuscript to this ballet scene. He writes, "Out of the turbulence of their emotions, a kaleidoscopic terror of the events pours over them, and a chaotic tumbling covers the stage, surging about. Desperately, they cling to each other. There must be a better world and a better place. Things must go well for them somewhere. Out of this storm, like reaching an island, comes a sudden stillness, a quiet, a refuge." Now, at the time Leonard Bernstein was working on this ballet scene from West Side Story, he was a very busy man. He was composing not one, but two Broadway shows at the exact same time, West Side Story and Candide. And on top of that, he'd also just been named the new music director of the New York Philharmonic and was booked conducting concerts all over the world. So when it came time to write the music for this ballet in West Side Story, Lenny had little time to waste. To ease his workload, he decided to use music he'd already written. You see, Lenny had a tune he'd been carrying around in his back pocket for years, and with this ballet, he finally had the chance to use it. And it went like this. And so as he begins to weave this tune, his trunk song, into the ballet score, Lenny begins to realize that this tune can be way more than just a musical theme. It needs to sing. But Jerome Robbins doesn't want someone coming out on stage and singing a song in this ballet. He wants the moment to be danced. So a compromise is reached. Lenny gets his song, but the song will not be sung on stage. Instead, dancers will play out the moment from the stage, and Lenny's song will be sung from off stage, from the wings of the theater, by an unseen singer. As a conductor, Leonard Bernstein said that the best way to get to know a piece of music was to get to know the music that came before it. So let's take his advice and get to know some music that came before Somewhere. I'm going to play you excerpts from three pieces of music. And in each case, the excerpt is either conducted by or performed by Leonard Bernstein. And when the screen turns to red, that's the part I want you to really pay attention to. First up is a Beethoven piano concerto. Here we go. Next, an excerpt from The Burlesque for Piano and Orchestra by Richard Strauss. And finally, we have Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake. Okay, just to review, I'm going to play the parts of each excerpt where the screen went to red, one after the next. First, we had the Beethoven. Then the Strauss. And here's the Tchaikovsky. That's starting to sound a little familiar, isn't it? Let's look at it from one more angle. First, the Beethoven. And here's Bernstein somewhere. Here's the Strauss. Here somewhere. The Tchaikovsky. And somewhere. So, who actually wrote this tune? Was it Leonard Bernstein, or was it Beethoven, Strauss, and Tchaikovsky? Well, remember that Leonard Bernstein is both a composer and a conductor. Conductors are the stars of the orchestra. They stand at the center of the players and lead them through music by the great masters. So what does Leonard Bernstein, the composer, do with Somewhere? The exact same thing. He starts with Beethoven. Then a little Strauss. Some Tchaikovsky. And then a little bit of Bernstein. Then back to Beethoven. More Strauss. the Tchaikovsky again? And he starts to build it up for Bernstein, right in the center. All of this, 100% Bernstein. And then he goes back again to Beethoven. One more Strauss. And one last Tchaikovsky. Building it up again until we have Bernstein. The spotlight is on Bernstein. There are so many things you could talk about with the lyrics to Somewhere, including how Stephen Sondheim uses a single perfect rhyme for all the verses, and his striking use of alliteration, where each word begins with the same sound, as a kind of tool that builds to the big finish. But there are two things that Sondheim does that really make this song take flight. First, he engages the listener in a universal theme. Remember, as this scene was originally written, Tony and Maria are seen dancing on the stage, but they do not sing the song. The song is sung by an unseen singer off stage. So Sondheim keeps it general with his lyrics, the idea of sanctuary being expressed as a place for us, or peace and quiet and open air. If Sondheim had wanted to write lyrics that were specific to the characters of Tony and Maria, he might have written something like, "Let's find a house in Scarsdale." But he doesn't do that. Instead, he finds words which represent not only the idea of the scene, but a feeling that all of us have in common. That's what makes it universal. Secondly, Sondheim writes words that sing. By that, I mean that he uses syllables and sounds which allow the singer to fully open their voice and make beautiful sound. This is especially true on musical notes that are held out or sustained, the long notes, and even more true on the high notes. Someday, somehow, and even peace and quiet and open air. Not only does this make the song easier to sing and sound better, but for people with really big voices, the song becomes a potential powerhouse, an opportunity for them to show off their voice. One of the most amazing things about Stephen Sondheim's contribution to Somewhere is just the fact that he wrote his lyrics to a pre-existing tune by Leonard Bernstein. Once Jerome Robbins said yes to having a song in this ballet, Bernstein simply handed his tune over to Stephen Sondheim. And it's Sondheim, with his words, who made the song sing. So let's put it all together and have a look at the song that Leonard Bernstein and Stephen Sondheim created for that very first production of West Side Story in 1957. The original, Somewhere, from West Side Story.